The pandemic has changed everything around the world. The normal way of living has suddenly shifted to the new normal. The recently concluded school year was tougher than we thought, though. There's one thing that we are sure about, that no adversity, not even COVID-19, can stop us from continuing the commitment to render our dedicated service to our clientele who went through the crisis with us. It is indeed true that when the going gets tough, the tough, that's us, get going.
This day signifies our passion, commitment, and resilience to move forward despite all that have transpired in life.
Mariners Polytechnic College's Foundation of Legazpi City Albay Senior High School Department proudly presents its 4 commencement exercises for the school year 2020-2021 with the theme Strengthening the Quality of Education Amid the COVID-19 Pandemic via Facebook Live.
This time, let us all stand for the singing of the Philippine National Anthem.
Mga kababayan, ang pambansang awit ng Pilipinas.
Alam mo din yung pera sa sinamanan, alam ng puso sa tatipo'y buhay, lupang hinitan, doon ka nang magiging.
Let us hear words of welcome from our very own Vice President for Academic Affairs, Dr. Milagros S. Hispanico.
Our respected guest speaker for today's 4th commencement virtual exercises of Mariners Legazpi, Dr. Benjang. Our dear President, Madam Merly Jimenez San Pedro. College officials, Ms. Maria Luisa Ipura, Senior High School Principal, Mr. Romel Arquero, the head teacher, our MCs, June and Ms. Bo, senior high school teachers and staff, graduating students, parents, and our viewers, good day to everyone. Today marks a very significant celebration for our graduating students and parents. This marks the first ladder, the basic education of your struggle for your future career, so you can enjoy the fullness of life. Your theme for this occasion is strengthening the quality of education amidst the COVID-19 pandemic or kalidad ng edukasyon lalong patatagin sa gitna ng pandemya. This served as our guide and the pursuit of the delivery of our services to our dear students. We utilized various strategies in delivering this quality of education you deserve, which will be your preparation for your higher education career. We all know that you have faced many challenges as you progressed from your grade 11 studies up to this time, as if you had been sailing in rough seas because of typhoons, power interruptions, unemployment of your parents and sponsors, and many more. But you are with your parents, showing your perseverance, hard work, resiliency, and commitment. Finishing your senior high school level and facing more challenges in college or in the work sector of your choice. Our vision for our graduates is to become maritime and business professionals. Here at the college level, you can become ship captains, chief engineers, both men and women, cruise ship employees, customs brokers, hotel crew and managers, accountants, financial analysts, mechanical engineers, and other related fields. My dear graduates, we are welcoming all of you in our college level programs with the corresponding incentives. Dear graduates, sail on, pursue your careers. Many opportunities await you. Dear parents, let us continue supporting our children. Education is your best legacy for them. Thank you and congratulations to all.
Thank you, Dr. Esparago, for that warm welcome and greetings to our graduating students and viewers.
To present the candidates for graduation is Ms. Maria Luisa L. Ora, the principal of the Senior High School Department.
Madam Marty Jimenez San Pedro, President of Mariners Polytechnic Colleges Foundation of Legazpi City, Albay, Incorporated, I have the honor to present to you the candidates for graduation from the Senior High School Department of this institution for the school year 2020-2021, composing of 107 males and 58 females, a total of 165 graduating students. The number of students from the various tracks and strands are as follows. Under the academic track, we have 40 students from the Maritime Pre-Baccalaureate Marine Transportation, 21 candidates from Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics, 7 candidates from Accountancy, Business, and Management, 7 candidates from General Academic Strand, and 11 candidates from Humanities and Social Sciences. Under the Technical Vocational Livelihood Track, Home Economic Strand, with specialization in bread and pastry production, we have 10 candidates. 10 candidates from food and beverage services, 18 candidates from tourism, and 41 candidates from TVL Maritime Marine Transportation. I hereby certify that they have satisfactorily completed the requirements of the basic education curriculum prescribed by the K-12 Basic Education Program of the Department of Education. May I therefore request you, Madam President, to confirm their graduation.
To confirm this year's graduates and to give her address is Madam Merly Jimenez San Pedro, President of Mariners Legazpi.
By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees and the President of Mariners Polytechnic Colleges Foundation of Legazpi, Albay, Incorporated, and having been presented and duly certified by the Senior High School Principal, Mrs. Maria Luisa Ipura, that you have completed the basic requirements prescribed by the Department of Education under the Basic Education Curriculum, I now confirm you senior high school graduates of this institution for the school year 2020-2021. Congratulations.
A struggling boy from Ligmanan, whose humble roots from a farmer's family never dampened his spirit, that one day he will succeed and make his parents and family proud, got himself to successfully finish his education through hard work, became a pandesal boy, literally walked his way to school, became a working student, and set up what we now know as reputable maritime and business educational institutions in the Bicol region. Who is he? our very own founder, Commodore Jaime C. Jimenez Sr. Last week, in a fitting tribute to our founder, we shortlisted and recognized 4 exemplary students and 2 faculty members similarly situated with the founder, taking a job as a sand and aggregates quarry part-time worker, sales kakanin on the side, nag-uuma, and skips meals to be able to save for school requirements, working as part-time crew member in a fast food chain, or even being a household cleaner. All of them facing financial difficulties due to their economic conditions, but coping well with the difficulties in life before and after and during the pandemic. I take exception to these role models and sterling examples of our students and faculty who show their dedication to education, which our institution matches with its commitment to quality education amidst the COVID-19 pandemic situation. At the outset, I would like to express my appreciation for the hard work of the faculty and staff members, along with the Mariners Polytechnic College's Foundation, Legazpi City Senior High School, graduating class of academic year 2020-2021. I congratulate all of you for this achievement, which is made possible by your commitment to the mission and vision of our institution. Despite the challenges of the COVID-19 pandemic, you're all here taking part in this meaningful ceremony that marks the culmination of your years of academic endeavor. I extend my greetings and compliments to the parents, relatives, guardians, and friends of our graduating class. Likewise, I would like to acknowledge the presence of Dr. Raul B. Bendain, Education Program Supervisor and senior high school focal person of the Department of Education of Region 5. This year's commencement exercises, the 4th since we have started offering the program, is focused on the theme, Strengthening Quality Education Amidst COVID-19 Pandemic. The world has indeed changed drastically because of the pandemic, and the education sector is one of those greatly affected. The effect in the Philippine education is tremendous. That of an official of the United Nations Children's Educational Fund, or the UNICEF, has remarked that the Philippines education sector may have suffered more than those in its Asian neighbors due to the effects of the COVID-19 pandemic. And this is unfortunate and saddening, considering that World Bank report indicates our basic education is lagging behind even before this global health problem. But you hang on to your dreams and aspirations, and you have chosen and proven that you can prevail over adversities. I'm sure each one of you has a story to tell about your hardships in pursuing education, your struggles in getting connected to online classes and examinations, the stress and disappointments, and the temptation to discontinue somehow became part of your daily challenges. On our part, as the institution you have chosen and your parents have trusted, we did what we believe were the necessary components to establish and strengthen the structure within which you will be shaped into what we envision you to be. ready to take on new challenges in higher education, armed with the knowledge and skills necessary to go on building a career not only for yourselves, but also for your families. Your alma mater continued to fortify the educational services by finding and applying innovative ways of dealing with the current and foreseeable challenges. We are one with the Department of Education and its drive. As Secretary Brion said, she's hopeful to further transform Philippine education in response to the changing world with the drastic changes in education brought by the pandemic. We support the Basic Education Learning Continuity Plan as the Department of Education's major response and commitment in protecting the health, safety, and well-being of learners, teachers, and personnel, and ensures that learning progresses among students despite the absence of face-to-face classes. Life may never be the same as we are to face and adapt to the new normal. The direction of our institution's initiatives is towards the application of innovative approaches in dealing with the current and future situations. This was the theme of our 36th Foundation anniversary, which we just celebrated last August 4. To prevail in the current situation requires a lot more than just acceptance and adjustments. It requires out-of-the-box thinking, that even what others think as crazy ideas may turn out to be the best option after all. Building innovative approaches is the way to go, as the current situation calls for it. Conventional or traditional ways may still work, but it is through innovation that we find and establish more effective and efficient ways to move forward. We strengthen quality education through innovative means and ways. Our alphas, or alternative and flexible academic scheme, has combined the utilization of synchronous and asynchronous modalities so that no one student is left behind. Different modalities were used given some challenges in connectivity. With assurance and assistance of DepEd, access to private schools for learning modules was provided with some modifications as appropriate. Learning from laboratory activities were provided. Research outputs via Google Classroom were delivered as proof that the pandemic situation did not hinder the students from achieving their basic learning activities. Our support services for student development and welfare programs play important role to care for our students' mental wellness through our Kugus Tugang program to promote empowerment during this COVID-19 pandemic in the different psychosocial trainings we conducted and counseling sessions provided to the students and members of the community. By adopting innovative approaches to learning, Mariners ensures that we address the needs of our students in a holistic manner, making them, as our tagline finds it, jobs fit and life ready. Again, we are beyond grateful to the parents of our students for entrusting their children to Mariners during their senior high school years. As one of the most reputable higher educational institutions in maritime and in business here in the Bicol region, we look forward to your continued stay with us as you embark on your chosen maritime or business program. To our dear students, should you embark on a degree program in maritime and business, Mariners will warmly welcome you to prepare you to join our ever-increasing ranks of successful maritime officers, business professionals, as customs and mechanical engineers, and hospitality frontliners and supervisors, managers and educators serving the different industries. All the best as you embark on your journey carrying the mariner spirit and our core values of competence, discipline, social responsibility, honesty, and loyalty. As I join the Board of Trustees, officials, and faculty, personnel of Mariners Polytechnic College's Foundation of Legazpi, congratulate you on your graduation day. We delightfully bid you instead the words, Padagos kamo sa Mariners. God bless you and stay safe always.
Thank you, Madam Merly Jimenez and Pedro.
With great privilege and honor, we introduce and welcome our commencement speaker.
He is a graduate of Doctor of Education at Bicol College Graduate School, the Education Program Supervisor 1, and Senior High School Division Focal Person at School District Office SDO Legazpi City, a song and dance composer, artistic director and artist, festival consultant, and playwright. Ladies and gentlemen, our commencement speaker, Dr. Raul B. Bandiag.
To the Board of Trustees of Mariners Polytechnic College's Foundation Incorporated, the Senior High School Department, to the President, Madam Merly San Pedro, the Vice President for Administration, Conrado L. Cordero, the Vice President for Academic Affairs, my mentor, Dr. Milagros S. Esparago, to the Principal, a good friend of mine, Madam Maria Luisa Ipurak, to the parents, to the graduating students, or to the graduates of Mariners Polytechnic College's Foundation Incorporated, Senior High School Department, and to all of you who are enjoying and witnessing this virtual graduation ceremony, friends, ladies and gentlemen, good day to everybody. First, it is a great honor and privilege for me to be invited as your guest speaker for this fourth commencement exercises for senior high school. I admire and I salute you for venturing in this prestigious school. To the graduates, congratulations. You are part of this institution, the Mariners Polytechnic College's Foundation Incorporated. You can shout to the whole world that you are a graduate of this school because this school is a very prestigious school in all over the world. Sa lahat na dako ng mundo, ang paaralan ito ay kilalang kilala because of the commitment, because of the opportunity, because of the virtue, the integrity, as well as the dedication of all the people involved in this institution. If you will notice, I am speaking for COVID, the commitment. All of the teachers as well as the school administrators are very much committed in the delivery of the curriculum just to finish your career as senior high school students. All of them has exerted effort to strengthen the quality of education that are due to you. To all of you graduates, congratulations also for your commitment as a student. In like manner, the commitment of your parent to this school, the commitment of your loved ones, including the family, because without them, perhaps, you might find difficulty in tackling all of the challenges that comes along your way. The opportunity that this school has given you has strengthened all of your academic discipline. It involves the development of the total humanity, wherein you are now at this stage, a graduate of senior high school of this school. The virtue that this school has provided with you has molded you become true human as well as an everyday individual who are going to go to the next ladder of your academy. The integrity of this school, your integrity being students, has go hand in hand in the development of your goal as well as the mission and vision of the school. In like manner, the dedication of your teachers who have provided you with all the necessary requirements as senior high school students, and now you are a senior high school graduate. Mga kaibigan, nagsipagtapos kayo dito sa pinakamaganda at pinakamahusay na eskwelahan. Pagyamanin natin ito at ipagbunyi sa lahat na dako ng daigdig saan man kayo pumunta that you are a graduate of Mariners Polytechnic Colleges Foundation Incorporated Senior High School. Sa school na ito, dito kayo nahubog. Hinubog ninyo ang inyong kahusayan at mga kagalingan sa larangan ng iba't ibang track and strand na inyong tinahak in preparation for your future. Next year, you will be venturing in your college. Please do the same. Huwag niyong kalilimutan na galing kayo dito sa paaralang ito. Sa paaralang ito, dito kayo namulat at dito kayo nagkaroon ng lakas na loob para pagyamanin ang iyong mga talento sa larangan ng akademika at sa lahat na aspekto ng edukasyon. To the proud parents, congratulations! Please continue sending your sons and daughters here in this school. Maraming salamat sa suporta ninyo sa paaralang ito. Because without you, of course, baka mawawala rin yung Mariners sa larangan ng akademika. So maraming salamat sa inyo, dear parents. And congratulations. I know that you are the happiest parents in this world. As of this moment, napakagandang ngiti. Ngiti ng tagumpay at ngiti ng pagtatapos ng inyong mga anak. Subalit, ang iyong mga duties and responsibilities as parent ay magsisimula pa lamang because they are going to proceed to the next ladder of their education life. Sa lahat naging inspiration ninyo, mga graduates, say thank you to them. Lalo na sa parents ninyo, to the school administrators as well as to the teachers. Huwag niyong kalilimutan na naging bahagi sila ng inyong tagumpay. Gayon din, ipagpatuloy ninyo ang iyong ambisyon. Go beyond the limit when it comes to formulating your your ambitions in life. Liparin mo ang tugatog ng inyong tagumpay. Abutin mo ang iyong pangarap because sa edukasyon, dito ay mayroong kabuluhan at kahalagahan ang buhay. To all of you, thank you very much and good luck everybody. Mabuhay kayong lahat.
Thank you, Dr. Benjen, for the moving and really inspiring speech as you encourage our graduates to remain focused while pursuing their dreams despite the pandemic.
We have now come to the most awaited part of our ceremony, the recognition of the graduates. We commend their hard work and perseverance despite the sudden shifting of the educational system. We likewise recognize the unwavering support of their parents and guardians to enable the children to surpass this trying time.
May I present to you the graduates of Accountancy, Business, and Management.
Acuña Ella Aliha O. Bea Rica May. Bron Kenneth Joy D. with honors. Coralde Caril Leca C. with honors. Diaz Eliza Jean E. with honors. Choso Jelin A. with honors. Hormina Caril S.
General Academic Strength.
Valderrama Pam D. Belbes Waylin M. Diaz Kathleen Joy C. with honors. Ebuenga Shane Ashley B. Elizondo Cerela Josh J. with high honors. La Chica Neil Sharwin B. Remot Joshua Troy A.
Humanities and Social Sciences.
Ardales Ivral D. with honors. Valeta Maria Paula with honors. Bariso Jillian B. with high honors. Barameda Angela H. Carascal Carlene B. Elioro Denise Gabriel M. Dones Angelo P. Lita Keith Arvin P. with honors. Noreen Laika May P. with honors. Olavario Ace B. Pamada Junior Gerald M. with honors.
Science, Technology, Engineering, and Mathematics.
Almeida Daniela L. with honors. Anda Paulo M. with honors. Añonuevo Adam William A. Balbir Jomari C. with honors. Banyares James Andrew R. Barugo Maria Wina B. with honors. Vilches Ian Cesar M. Belen Janrig V. with high honors. Bello Anjali L. Cabrera Christine S. with honors. De Los Santos John Andrew S. Tia Dion Lexi with high honors. Ismeria Shan Owen D. Nandina Liza May B. with honors. Sarmiento Raisa Jasmine N. with honors. Tugado Nika M. with honors. Valladolid Paul John A. Vergara Stephanie G. with honors. Yanzon Janrens B. with honors.
May I present to you the graduates of Pre-Baccalaureate Maritime Specialization.
Adato Fort C. Aguilar Alvin Joshua A. Alamares Runel H. with high honors. Almoguera John Mark L. with honors. Banyadera Mark Justin. Barrios Prince Benric C. with high honors. Basabe Roland Jr. D. With honors. Biliesa Klein, Timothy D. Bumbon, Miggy Agostos B. With high honors. Bukeo Juniper B. Borbo John Karel C. With honors. Borlasa Froilan U. Wendia Christy B. With high honors. Wendia Patrick S. With honors. Cassie Hinaro C. Kayaban Ireland F. With high honors. Cordoves Jeremy C. With high honors. De Los Reyes Emil F. With honors. Hojilia Marjun Chloe E. Yupando Justin Dale M. With honors. Lorin Venicer Jr. G. With honors. Lupo Kenneth S. With honors. Lucinario Paulo C. Makasiinag John Kenneth M. With honors. Malvar John Raymond M. With honors. Mary John Jermel B. Olaybal Justin Clyde P. With honors. Panghubasan Harlin P. With honors. Raka Arvin CJ M. With high honors. Ragos Kyle Andre S. Rivancos Art Luis P. With honors. Regalado Luigi Nicolas V. Rosagas Michael Joshua B. With high honors. Saturnino Alvin Vincent M. Chaton John Russell F. Sibay Fritz Andre P. With honors. Tario Tony Mil S. Teston Edo C. With honors, Villarito Ray Ann. With honors, Zueta Alfonso Kyle E. With honors.
May I present to you the graduates of Technical Vocational Review Maritime Specialization.
Adore Ray Michael B. With honors. Amados Robert R. Arborilla Charmel B. Arienda Raymark B. Balangat Jan Ivan V. Balingit Ken Angelo S. Balisnomo Ramel L. Barnuevo Mark Angelo R. With honors. Bea Justin Luis B. Belardo JP B. Benasa James L. Bigno John Ace M. With honors. Bitangkur Yuri B. Bulawan Shakilshan T. Bunal JJ B. With honors. Kadag Jaysor B. Chua Charles B. With honors. Corteza Matthew A. With honors. De Los Santos Darrell T. Diaz Conrado S. Espeña Henry Clark L. Espina Francisco Jr. D. Giriba Kent L. With honors. Jardiniano Arvin A. Marticio Giselle E. Marzan John Paul N. Mendez Ero P. Mestas Jojim A. Muring Greggy M. Nerva Charles Nico L. Orozco Michael M. Paitim Daniel John. Papika Ivan Titus B. Perdigon Ralston Chris O. Cunyado AJ Allen A. Ramos Mark Brian O. Rania Elijah Ray C. Raniola Fernando Jose Martin P. Robas Jude Brian E. with honors. Salisi Aljay G. Vinyas Kit Luis C.
May I present to you the graduates of DBL Home Economics Bread and Pastry Production.
Abion Cyrus Danray. Azurian Tricks and Fate E. Balabias Charles Julian J. with honors. Belga Cherry Joy A. Belio Florian L. Landicho Clarissa S. Magna Rigel Kent A. Mirandilia Ashley D. Rizare Hazel Joy B. Tore Roy Kenneth B.
DBL Home Economics Food and Beverage Services.
Abrera Irish R. with honors. Balasta John Denmark B. Baldres Patrick Jairus B. with honors. Bethsaida Joshua Alan A. D. Delgado Christian Carl R. Hatikeyama Sakura G. Legson Carl Angelo C. Thomas Trisha A. with honors. Toledo Sean Christian M. with high honors. Trillies Jade Vincent B.
TVL
Home Economics, Teresa. Aninuevo Ashley A. with honors. Atractivo Donica K. B. with honors. Bellinius Joella Marie S. with high honors. Baloloy Christine Joy B. with honors. Marcela Micaela L. with honors. Barotilia Nika with honors. Gladys Hannah N. with honors. Bertumen Kristen Joy B. Bongalon Melissa Joy A. Carrasco Giselle N. with honors. Cruel Caril Ann B. Deskaya Juris April C. with high honors. Luzanyes Princess G. with honors. Lucis Brian Bernadette P. Olaibal Joanna May E. Rafael Rafaela May C. with others. Rimulta Gavin Rosedale. Sanes Ashley Lian N. with honors.
Congratulations to the graduates and awardees. We, your school, is very proud of you, and we join your parents in celebrating your much-deserved success.
To give her valedictory address is Ms. Joella Marie Espalinis from the Technical Vocational and Livelihood Home Economic Strength, specializing in tourism.
When Denise said I was going to deliver my speech as the batch valedictorian came, I was ecstatic. It wasn't the medals that I was looking forward to, but the congratulations and I'm proud of yous from my family and friends. My imagination wandered, and I could vividly see and hear the shouts and cheers my classmates would have given me if it weren't for the situation we have right now. It was a moment of realization that at the end of the day, none of the physical articles could ever equate to the physical bonds we have with the people around us. To our indefatigable President, Madam Merly Jimenez San Pedro, to our esteemed Board of Trustees, to our goal-driven school officials, to our hard-working principal, Madam Maria Luisa L. Iporac, to our honored guest speaker, Dr. Raul B. Benjan, untiring teachers and staff, proud parents, fellow graduates, online viewers, a pleasant morning to all of you. We can all agree that this academic year is far from what we have envisioned our senior year would be. Everyone was gravely affected. The news was filled with COVID-related deaths that are rapidly increasing. Face-to-face classes were put on hold. Livelihood for most people has been suspended, and our daily interactions has been put in a disarray since this global outbreak. Without a doubt, no one saw it coming. Oblivious to us, that regular Friday afternoon turned out to be our last. Boy, mo yung magpakantin? Boy, ibahin naman ako sa CR? Boy, sabay kita magulit chan? That was our last day together in a normal classroom setup. It wasn't what we could have had, but what we had and we took for granted that I regret the most. Tight hugs from friends, loves and interactions with our teachers, and those simple yet meaningful connections that we thought we would experience the next Monday. Nevertheless, all the lasts bring out some of our firsts as well. Our first Google Meet, our first digital classroom experience, and although it will never replace the normal face-to-face interaction, this just goes to show that this unprecedented and unconventional year did not deter us from utilizing what we have given the circumstances. After the tedious juggling of online exams, college applications, and household chores, at last, we made it. The seed we planted 6 years ago was now borne fruit. And although virtual, we should celebrate this milestone. My takeaway from this journey is to not dwell on the what-ifs and what could-have-beens. Let the death cases be a frightening reminder that any day could be anyone's last. To live meaningfully, to love passionately, and to dream fearlessly, knowing that all of this will come to an end someday. That, for me, is the meaning of life. On that note, I encourage everyone to be fearless in the pursuit of what makes you happy. Your aspirations are valid, even if it doesn't fit the mold of what is deemed as successful. Do not be afraid to grab every opportunity to take a meaningful stand against oppression and injustices. Most importantly, know how to sincerely thank people who help you no matter how small or big it is. With all that being said, on behalf of the senior high school graduates, I would like to thank the administrators headed by President Merly Jimenez San Pedro and Ms. Maria Luisa Iporac, as well as the staff and the faculty. Thank you for the wisdom you bring, for making the tough calls when needed, for giving your best each day, and for pushing us to be the best. I will treasure my short but meaningful stay in Mariners Legazpi. Thank you for providing us with the tools and resources we needed to succeed in school and later in life. To my teachers who believed in me and supported me every step of the way, Ma'am Bo, Ma'am Aileen, Ma'am Borja, Sir Estay, Sir Abedo, Sir Armenta, and to those that haven't been mentioned but encouraged me in one way or another, thank you so much. You are the true heroes of today. Your efforts and sacrifices transcend even the barriers of distance and technological learning. To the best advisor one could ever ask for, Ma'am Kat, thank you. I am grateful beyond words for all the times you have rooted for me without me knowing, for the life lessons you shared more than what textbooks could ever give, for the efforts you have exerted just for me to be where I am now. Nothing could ever fathom my sincerest gratitude. To the most humble principal who speaks her ideals through her actions, Ma'am Iquara, I will make sure to come back when I'm established and successful. In the meantime, I wish you the best in your endeavor. As the saying goes, a good teacher explains, a superior teacher demonstrates, but a great teacher inspires, and you have inspired galaxies of greatness and goodness within us. And for that, I am thankful. Senior high school would not have been memorable if it weren't for our dear classmates. To my fellow tall tourism dreamers, when I look up the sky, I will remember you. Now don't get too emotional. That's only because looking up gives me headaches. When I was elected as year's keeper, I didn't really think much about it because what could go wrong, right? Spoiler alert, a lot. Kidding aside, be successful. And I don't mean the conventional one. Regardless of how you perceive success, make sure you achieve that. As Donica, Tin, Mika, Nika, Hannah, Tin, Melissa, Giselle, Karil, Juris, Princess, Rihan, Joanna, Rafa, Gavin, Ashley, wherever life takes all of you, make sure it's somewhere your 18-year-old selves would be proud of. A special acknowledgement to Juris, since day one, I knew it was just a matter of time before we become friends. We are basically the same person except that you're taller and I am prettier. Thank you for the late night chicas. Whenever I tell you I have 5 missing activities, somehow we still have 10. And that instantaneously makes me feel like I'm doing better than what I actually am. Thank you for not letting me suffer alone. To someone really close to my heart, we've come a long way, didn't we? It's heartwarming to embark on this new journey with you. Thank you for the constant support and validation. I will always be proud of you too. To my fellow graduates, class of 2021, hats off to all. You have my utmost admiration for demonstrating bravery, camaraderie, and dedication to get through these trying times. Let the bonds you have shared and the learnings you have gained in Mariners Legazpi be a driving force for you to cross oceans for your dreams. More than anyone, I would like to dedicate this recognition to the people behind the scenes. I wouldn't have been here without their constant support. They are the pillars of my success. To my mom, thank you for being my front buddy, my cameraman, and my all-around supporter. Thank you for bringing me a drink whenever I have to pull an all-nighter. Thank you for putting up with me and my endless complaints. Thank you for all the sacrifices, and thank you for always doing your best. Numerous times you have told us not to end up like you. But if I could be a little bit just like you are, I know my future children would be proud, because Kuya and I are very proud of you. To my dad, thank you for taking double jobs just so you could finance my studies. I haven't thanked you yet for buying me ice cream when I had an academic breakdown. Your hands are calloused just so I can hold a pen. I appreciate you so much. Diyot na lang. I will make every effort to give you the life you both deserve and should have had. To my kuya, I aspire to be as eloquent as you are. Thank you for being an inspiration. I wouldn't have had the courage to try out a lot of things if you didn't pave the way for me. Thank you for taking the first steps. I had it easy because of you. To my aunts and uncles, Toli, Mio, Dada, Tio, Tien, Nana, you all are witnesses of my ups and downs. For the guidance and support, I will forever be thankful. To my cousins, Nicole, Harry, Roby, thank you so much for understanding that sometimes I cannot play Roblox because I have to finish an activity. I will work hard to buy your favorite characters. Marcy, I am rooting for you. I am proud of all of you and I'm always here if you need help. To my grandparents, Nai, Tai, thank you for instilling important values in me, for being there during triumphs and tragedies. Thank you for the everlasting love. Most importantly, all praise and glory to our Almighty Father for the gift of life, wisdom, and grace. Amidst this pandemic, His guidance allowed us to have another fruitful school year filled with hope, joy, and learnings. While another chapter of our lives now come to an end, another slowly begins or has begun to some. College. I too am afraid of the uncertainty the future presents. But at the end of the day, it's okay to do it with shaky hands and trembling knees. They say that diamonds are formed under pressure. I say not everything is meant to be a diamond, and that doesn't make them insignificant. I hope you turn fear and criticism into an inspiration to pursue your passion and fulfill your purpose. Let the values you have learned as Mariner Yan equip you for your next journeys in life. In addition, being the first ever woman to deliver her valedictory speech in Mariner's Legazpi Senior High School Department, I wouldn't let this opportunity pass without raising the banner for all the women watching right now. Babae kita, baho babae sana. In a predominantly male institution, it's an honor to represent you all. As I end my speech, I hope you remember that with courage, love, and faith, everything is possible. Graduates, a big congratulations to all of you. Good luck, and never let anyone dim the light from your burning passion. Thank you.
Thank you, Joella, and congratulations.
To lead the graduates for the Pledge of Loyalty is Sirella Josh J. Elizondo, the President of Class 2021.
Pledge of Loyalty. In grateful recognition of all that my alma mater has done for me, and in deep consciousness of my responsibilities, I hereby pledge to her my loyalty and promise to live according to her ideals. May the wisdom that I have gained sustain me always in promoting the cause of truth and justice. May I never fail to keep the trust of spreading what she taught me, the know-how, virtue, dignity of man, and above all, the unity of mankind. So help me God.
Graduation marks the end of one chapter of your life and the start of an exciting new one. While you're so looking forward to the new journey ahead, saying goodbye to the friends and the teachers who have been by your side the past 2 years isn't easy. To help you get through the nerve-wracking, totally scary, completely exhilarating moments, ladies and gentlemen, the graduation song of Batch 2021.
Once upon a younger year, when all our shadows disappeared, the animals inside came out to play. Went face to face with all our fears, learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. He took me in his arms, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day you'll leave this world behind, so live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights to never die. My father told me, can't put out, carve your name into those shining stars. He said go venture far beyond the shores, don't forsake this life of yours. I'll guide you home no matter where you are. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. When I was just a kid, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day you'll leave this world behind, so live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights that never die. My father told me, I
Thank you very much, graduates. Good luck on your future endeavors.
As an expression of our loyalty to our alma mater, let us all join the singing of the MPCF hymn. From the Senior High School Department, we thank everyone for celebrating with us the 4th Commencement Exercises and the 2nd Virtual Graduation Ceremony of Mariners Legazpi. This has been Regina Bo
and Jumar Basmayor saying thank you for watching. Dios Matagos, Sendong Gabon!